Now we're actually online. Hello and welcome back to the second test stream I am running for Star Trek Online. At the moment I am currently docked in orbit around Earth, as you can see, with a giant mushroom just parked over there. And I am on a mission to report on Borg activities. So I've got to go to find the Romulan ambassador on Earth space dock. So before going there, I just want to quickly show off the ship at the moment. This is the Prometheus class ship with the multi-vector assault mode, which I shall just demonstrate now. Three different parts of the ship there: alpha, beta, and gamma modules. Each one's got a slightly different focus to it, so one is more, I suppose you could say, tactical, the other is more engineer, and the third is more sort of science. Each gives a bonus to various aspects, so one can move faster, one can attack better, but the others do help out as well. But just quickly cancel that and then watch them come back in and they fly off, and they come back in again. So let's get on with this mission and see how it goes. Dock. Now, as you've probably guessed, this character is one I've been playing for a little while now. When I start officially streaming, I will be creating a new character from scratch and following their progression from the beginning all the way up to this stage now. So let's have a quick tour around Starbase. Here, this is the transporter room where you beam in. Over here is the Admiral's office, space dock operations, and here is the Admiral. So that's the dude I've got to talk to over there, but we'll come back to him in a minute. There's Earth. It's very pretty. Quick look, see around here. Oops, no, can't actually jump up on there, that's a bit of a mistake. Over here, this is a hologram of Starbase 1. Lucky, yep, here we go. If you look up here, that is what's called the Galaxy X. Now, if you've seen the Star Trek episode All Good Things, that is the one that drops out of warp, decloaks, and gives the Klingon a new one with its cannon on it. Yeah, I think that's a Vulcan ship up there. There's a few more to show as well. Now, if you've ever played any MMO, Star Trek Online is pretty similar to it. You've got the NPCs to get your missions from, although you can talk to them offline. You can talk to them through subspace. There are missions you can get from certain people, like this fellow, who's a Kaiten. You can claim bits and pieces. I'm not going to do it now because it's... I might claim the combat suit because that's quite good. And that has got me Federation Combat Environmental Suit. That's for like when you go outside, like on the first contact. My current gear I've got at the moment. Let's continue the tour. And there's a reason why I'm doing it this way. It's because behind me is a ship, and this is going to be the ship that I'm aiming for with this guy. It's very nice. So yes, I am running backwards deliberately. Should be getting there very... Here we go. Right. This is where you actually get your ships. And this is the Hestia. This will be the ship that this guy here is going to be aiming for. I've been playing Star Trek Online probably since beta. So I've built up a few credits, ships and stuff I can claim, and other bits and pieces. This is my dream ship. For this guy anyway. I've got plenty of other characters. I've got Klingons, I've got Romulans, other bits and pieces. Okay, let's quickly head back to our contact, which I think is, yep, he's in the office as I thought the first time. Okay. Oh, it's because I got close to it, right. I've got to speak to that's the Romulan ambassador. Red Wolf. Yeah. Nice easy quest. I get some experience points and expertise. And that's just to take you to one of the reputation areas on New Romulus. I'm not going to do it right now because I've done it quite a few times and it's a bit of a long-winded spot. We'll cover it eventually, but just not right now. Okay, let's move out of here. Galaxy X again. See what missions I've got available. Episodes, sorry. Let's see. Just did that one. Oh, hello. Mission coming through there. This is called Where Angels Fear to Tread. There's the usual sort of blurb there. Expertise, dilithium, which is like one of the more premium currencies which you use to pay for the bigger ships, the more potent gear, doing upgrades and so on and so on. And those are the two bits of equipment I've got. I've got slightly better equipment than this because I've been doing a few of the other missions. But if you're following the mission progression, you've been unlucky enough not to get something that's good. You end up getting choice. It's reasonable gear. It's reasonable. It's not fantastic, but it will do you. You know, you don't need to get every single badass ship in the game. It just makes it just a bit easier. I'm going to accept that. Okay. Now, I've got several choices here. I can either fly there manually, which actually I think I will do, or I can transwarp, which is like which I'll show you here. It will cost me 20,000 credits to take me to my destination in the Beta Quadrant, but I don't want to do that. I want to show you. I'm going to show you Sector Space. Well, let's quickly check something. That's loading up. Here we are. Now if you look at that bad boy, that is the Enterprise J. Yeah, that thing's huge. It's ridiculous. Let's do a little flight. Let's do a little flyby around it so you can see it. Yeah. Now, I'm in the Prometheus. Oh, so let's get the ball from here. So then Nakira. I think possibly a scimitar, there's a vengeance class, but that's just disgustingly huge. It's ridiculous. But if I remember rightly, it costs a ridiculous amount of credits, or you can only get it through a particular lockbox, which I know there's a bit of controversy about lockboxes at the moment, but at least there is a way you can get it within the game. It's not exclusive. You can't only get it for that. You have to put up a lot of in-game credits to do so, but it is possible. But and to be fair, I can understand why some people don't like them. So anyway, let's just pick a destination, and I want to go to there. So let's go to Sector Space. My drink. Oh, that's going to warp. Vulcan, very very close to the Vulcan system. When it drops you out, because Vulcan and Sol are really close, sometimes you end up really close to Vulcan. But there's Sol, Earth, and all the other ships there. But let's head to wherever this is. I'm going to auto navigate, so I'll show you a few of the other features that are around in the game as well. Oops, it's crashing at the start, don't want it. It's taking the pretty route, I see, rather than just turning around on the spot. Yes, the old joke about the ships not being able to go into reverse. At the moment, I'm travelling at Transwarp 12.34. I do have slipstream on this particular ship, which makes it go really fast, but you can only go in a straight line. As we're travelling there, that's where I am now, and where am I heading to? That's where I'm heading to. So I've got plenty of time. Let's quickly show you some of the other features. First of all, let's look at the character sheet. Not the most particularly powerful character. Got a few bits and pieces, spaces for new characters. I've also got a few holograms which I picked up a long time ago. Saurian there, that's the first officer you get. I think she's a Bolian. Yeah, Bolian. Yes, I've got Jem'Hadar working for me as my head of security. Vulcan, I think he's my second in command. Another hologram, but this guy's a Trill. And here you have your skills. These determine how well, obviously, your powers and abilities work and what you can unlock and stuff like that. There's quite a few options to choose from. Although you can't really make any mistakes, it's when you're selecting each option, it's always a good idea just to read them, see what they do. Do a bit of research. You can get retrains, but they cost. Ground skills as well. Here I've specialised in weapons, a little bit of shields, a little bit of kits, which are basically part of your equipment, and a little bit of health. Specialisation. This is where the game gets a little bit more interesting. You've got several different specialisations. Each one of these, as you level up from a certain point, you get points to spend in these. These can unlock new abilities or give you enhancements to existing ones. Like for example, this particular ability, Scan for Weakness, gives you 1% exposure, 1% chance to basically make your torpedoes that a little bit better. This particular one increases that chance. It's got this makes you run a little bit faster when you sprint, and there's different specializations. I've particularly gone for Intelligence Officer, which makes it makes me a little bit more deadly. Here you've got Miracle Worker, which is good if you want to be like an engineering type or
Once thought to be an unstoppable force, the Borg were dealt a heavy blow by Catherine Janeway and the crew of the USS Voyager. But the Borg are nothing if not resilient. They retreated, waited, planned, and they adapted. These are not the nightmares of Wolf 359. They are faster, aggressive, relentless, remorseless. What the Borg cannot assimilate, they will destroy.
Yes, that was Leonard Nimoy. May he rest in peace. Before he passed away, he did a lot of voiceovers for the game. So occasionally you will get things like the lore information pop up and describe the events and things that happened and stuff like that within the game itself. So it's always nice to hear him, but because it's been a while since I've had one of those, it completely threw me off. I forgot those were in the game. Okay, so we're close to the system. Let's just take her in. Slow down a little bit. So this episode is called Where Angels Fear to Tread.
This is Commander Talus of the Romulan Steyr Empire vessel, RNA. We are under attack by Borg scout squadrons. This is a formal request for assistance from any ship receiving this message. Do not abandon us.
We will assist, Commander. Let's go up this probe first of all. I've set up a few